everybody. It's Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa, and today is Zombies. And you can thank Mark M. for that because it's his birthday.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Happy birthday, Mike.
Sorry. On the mic, you hear my husband, John.
Hi, guys.
He is, there's a lot going on the background in the text, so he's there wrestling it. And also, he is reading the chat. So really, he's the voice of you. So if you have questions or comments, be sure and put them in all caps so that it's easy to see it. We got moderators today that are also looking that are going to be there to help you out through this really fun zombie painting.
Wait, do we have a whole room full of people here? I'm over here so busy pushing buttons. I'm all getting ready to go.
Are we a zombie fan group?
We are.
God.
We are. Look over here. Oh my gosh, look at that. We have over 150 people here. Well, it's 152, 57, 59. Oh, it's going up. They're all here just to celebrate. Happy birthday to
paint
Mark,
the zombie,
Pam, and Susan.
To not paint the zombie.
Yeah, Mark, Pam, and Susan.
That's all birthdays today?
All birthdays today.
Happy birthday, guys.
Happy birthdays.
You're on my canvas, too.
Oh, and Brandy is a first-time watcher today.
Hi, Brandy. I hope you're having a lot of fun.
And they all said they liked the new intro. So thank you, guys. We just decided to throw that up there and give it a try.
John made that. All himself. It's pretty cool. All right.
What are we doing today there?
Today, because Mark has asked for zombies for more than a year.
Mm-hmm.
And then his mom made me a hat.
His mom made you the most awesome hat?
So I couldn't mess with him anymore. I had to give him zombies. So these are for Mark. This is sort of based in, I don't know if you remember, movie Heavy Metal.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely foundational, fundamental movie for me growing up. And that kind of is my feeling of zombies and that kind of imagery. So it's definitely based in that. Here's the good news. You only need three colors. You only need black, white, and red. And any black, white, and red will do. I'm going to tell you what my black and white and red are. So you know exactly what I'm using. And that information is in the description below. But just whatever you have on this particular piece will work. And yes, there's going to be an after show with some glow and maybe a cracker.
Oh, yeah.
Because, you know, birthday.
Yeah, and we've already got that iCarded, or we've already got that set up so that we'll adjust that as we get close to the end here. But we're going to go through and get the painting done, and then we'll have the after party, right?
That'll be so fun.
Yeah.
I have wishes.
Oh, go. What's our wishes?
Well, I loved what today's wish is. Tammy has a wish of healing for her Papa Chuck. He's going in to get some surgery, and we want to just send him light, love, and healing.
Mm-hmm.
Dominique is having some thyroid health, and she needs some relief from migraines. And as someone who has thyroid health issues, I totally appreciate that. Of course, happy birthdays to Mark, Pam, and Susan.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And then we have Art High Fives to Jillian, because Jillian right now is one of my art heroes because she is sight impaired and still painting.
Oh, wow.
She's
not letting
anything slow her down
and
stop her.
That's right.
So I'm pretty impressed by Jillian. I also want to give some high fives to my art heroes, Daisy, Emily, and Karen, who have been closed captioning so much stuff and making this content accessible for other people in the world. And of course, I also wish for safety for the victims of all the flooding that's going on right now everywhere.
Yeah. And
please be safe.
You know, there's a lot of light keepers out here catching a lot of the wishes that are going out in here. We've got a whole bunch of people here. Really appreciate that. And, you know, the one wish I think that we do need to squeeze in there is, you know, we need a cure for the T virus.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think, you know, that's something that's very, you know, important for today.
We'll give that some heart. And also perfect for, you know, today's subject.
Yeah.
Cure.
Hopefully we can count on our folks at Umbrella to work on that.
Yeah. Yeah. It's important.
So
really important. It's ruining and painting, guys.
So right. Can you show us what our palette is today?
Today I'm actually using Mars Black, Titanium White, and Naphthol Red. I like a crimson just for myself personally because it reminds me of blood. But again, any red you have in this particular piece will work. And I'm going to use some acrylic glazing liquid by Golden.
Mm-hmm.
The packaging on this, I've noticed, is different at Jerry's Artorama. And so I think it's given some people some trouble finding it. But remember, I also like the Grumbacher retarder. So there's lots of products that are good. I just have the ones I enjoy using, and I like sharing that with you. So you know what I've got going on.
Mm-hmm.
I am going to use this nice 2-inch brush.
Yes.
Right? I got this at Michael's. This is like an artist loft.
Oh, yeah?
But I think the one that you have in your house, you know, to paint it would probably also work for these purposes. And I'm going to pull a little white out, and I'm going to get a little black on the brush. Get a little of my glazing, and I'm going to come and just come across to create this water effect. I just want a streaking gray water effect. And what I'm noticing there, right there, is that I had the brush too wet. And if that ever happens to you, what you do is you keep dragging across and then you wipe the brush on a towel. If that's ever happened, you're like, how do I fix that? That's how.
I see.
So here, I just don't want to, I want to get a gray, but I don't want to overmix it. And you could do this with, you know, your regular brushes. You don't have to have a big brush at all. But I do want to try to keep my streaks in the water kind of horizontal. That'll save me some work later. I like using this big brush, John.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I like that too.
I needed to paint today.
Yeah. I'm totally lost my good music vibe here, and I'm trying to find... Because I had it all queued up, but then my little window closed.
Oh, I'm sorry, sweetie.
I lost all my good music cues.
It's terrible. All right.
So I'll put something mellow on here just for a second, and then I'll get some.
Okay. I think as long as we're with our friends, celebrating birthdays, having a little art, I hope I get to see some zombies. I mean, I knew Mark was going to paint them.
Oh, yeah.
And I know if you check the iCard, there's a video by Chuck Carson that is for Mark's birthday. And it's really cute and fantastic. It's Mark as a zombie. And I think we're going to even maybe do that on a shirt, Zombie. And then just in case you're like, I have to have, you know, a memory. And then also, I know the Jink and Data Girl had done a shout out, and a lot of people are doing zombie art today in honor of Mark's birthday. And if you click his little name, he has a YouTube channel as well, and you could go by and subscribe as a birthday present.
I think I found that. Where did it go? Yes, everyone needs to go by over there. I am so multitasking here.
No, you're doing great, babe.
There, I found it.
Yay. So it's fun because the pink watercolor is sort of picking up into my paint, but I think it's sort of adding to how the painting's going to come out. And what I'm trying to do is keep my streaks, level my water space, so when I put my vegetarian zombies...
They're gardening zombies.
They're gardening zombies. They have an issue with this walnut. They're really like on about it.
Yeah.
So just... getting that out there. It's fun and it's relaxing, and I'm really glad I get to do it today.
Yeah, no, I'm going to say thank you to everyone who's come and given us the likes. We've got over 100 likes already.
Really?
Thank you guys so much. So, you know, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And, you know, share so that, you know, if you have any friends that you'd like to come join us in the live, we'd love to have more friends along with us. And do please... Don't forget to give us the thumbs up, because those really help YouTube know that you were here and you like what you saw. And also, when we get to 300, we all do a little dance. So it's a lot of fun for everybody.
And I guess today it's the birthday dance.
Yeah, we have over 160 people in the room, too.
That is excellent. Thank you guys for coming today. I so appreciate it.
I do, too. And I think everybody, you know, Susan and Mark and who was the other one we had? We had Susan, Mark, and one more birthday. Let me go back and look.
Dominic, I painted over it.
Mark, Pam, and Susan.
Mark, Pam, Susan. There you go. Thank you, sweetheart.
I've got notes.
Like, why did I paint over it? No. So there we go. See, that's that nice first sort of streaky gray coat.
That looks really cool.
Right? And you don't have to use this big brush. That's not at all a requirement in any way. To get this effect, it just is super helpful if you've got one.
Yeah.
That's all. I gotta dry my canvas.
Are ya?
Well, I would, but I can't, because I messed up.
What did you you do?
I was the other day I was painting a ton of leaves, and I had the hair dryer over there, and so it's plugged in over there.
Oh no!
Oh no! I could wave at my painting.
Can we go get it for you?
I can go or you can go.
I will go get it.
You go get it. Okay, it's either one.
I'll go get it. You sit there.
Duh, sorry. Just glad to be with you guys. It's been a week. You did great. Hmm? I don't do so good?
I don't do so good.
Oh, none of us are doing that good today. You're doing great. I don't know. It's all good. They want to see you anyways. You've succeeded. John has not gone out of his pajamas today, so it's a win. He's literally working out how not to be on camera.
See, what we do is we go over here, and then you can see, and you can turn around and look at RoboCam.
Oh! RoboCam?
And I'll say, oh, I gotta go back over here because I was switching. And I'm
gonna
say, hi, RoboCam.
RoboCam, how are you doing? My favorite RoboCam that really can see. I always like that it moves. It reminds me of Johnny Five. Oh, his cleverness, right? John is like, I will not be on camera. But he is still in his pajamas, you know, which is a varying collection of Doctor Who pajamas, which is pretty awesome. Because who doesn't want that? Hi, Mark. How are you doing?
Okay, guys, I'm back. So, haha, we managed to do that. And look, there's 190 people in here in the room. So thank you guys. Thank you guys for all coming and joining us today. I really appreciate our all moderators who are coming today. Thank you. I so appreciate all your guys' help. As you know, I have lots of buttons to push and lots of things to do. So I really appreciate everybody being here with me. And don't forget, like I said, to like, comment, subscribe, and share, and join us in the after party where we're going to be doing some things like adding Kevin the Kraken and some blacklight stuff and all that other kind of stuff. And you'll find that if you're joining us in the time traveling zone later on. We'll have that iCarded and listed there. Also, in the iCard, if you'll go look, there is Chuck Carson's drawing that he did for Mark's birthday, and you can find that up there in the iCard. So definitely jump by Chuck Carson, the Animated Pencils channel, and give him a subscribe too while you're there. He's does some really cool stuff. There's a bunch of time-lapse videos over there. And gosh, she's leaving me here an extraordinarily long time, don't you think? So yeah, we had a pajama party. Oh, it's a pajama party for Mark. Is that what we're going to do? I see. So now I see we're about the place. Oh my gosh, look, it's perfectly timed. About the time that I really do run out of time, she comes back.
You're doing good. So I'm going to put some distant reflections.
Distant reflections.
Or deep, moody elements. For the deep moodiness.
The moodiness.
I don't know. Is anyone, I'm wondering who today is actually painting long. I'm kind of curious how many zombies I'm going to see in the feed. It's pretty exciting.
I'm pretty excited, too.
Back here in the upper third, down almost a third, I'm going to start some glazed kind of shadows in the water. Now, you could do this just by thinning your paint or using Liquitex glazing liquid. I'm using the golden, but what it really is we're just trying to make it slightly see-through. Not as powerful. You could just do it with a light dry brush or mix a gray. Lots of ways to get it done. There just is never one way to do something in a painting. I'm going to maybe put some of this back here, and you can see as I move it up, It gets lighter. The reason I like the glazing liquid instead of just thinning it with water, sometimes when you over thin acrylic paint, it does a thing called underbind. And then if you were trying to brush on a varnish or something, it might lift up.
Gotcha.
But that's sort of the nice, distant little... Now we know this water is disturbing in some way. We're telling a very, very dark story with our water. And that's nice because his head is going to go there.
Mm-hmm.
And you want some depth and dimension to the space. We should name this zombie, the this first one I'm going to sketch in here.
Uh-huh.
We should name him. I'm going to use a number four bright to sketch him in.
Oh, okay. So what kind of name are you thinking?
I don't know, like Carl.
Carl? I don't know. We could go with you know, community inspired.
I think community should name it because we know I name things like girl with dog and balloons.
Yeah,
so.
Joan voted for Mark. That was going to be my first vote.
Mark. All right. So this one right here is Mark.
It could be Mark.
Here's Mark. So Mark, when I'm drawing in Mark, I'm going to do nice little oval, and it's going to be almost a silver dollar size.
Okay.
I know I need to upload a bunch of traceables to Pinterest. And I probably will have to upload one for this. But I'm just going to sketch in that basic head shape, even though it's a rotting head.
Uh-huh.
But here's the good news. This does not require really perfect drawing skills because it's a very emotional, impressionistic piece.
Yep.
So you don't even have to be that stressed about it. Now here, almost just above the halfway line is where I'd put my eye line.
Mm-hmm.
And wherever the eye line is, we've got an ear. I like that Lisa says that your eyes and ears have to line up because that's where your glasses sit. And I thought that was super clever as a way of thinking of it. Your ears and your eyes need to line up because that's where your glasses sit. And I'm going to give him some story here, like some little craziness with his hair.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, if you're ever going to have a bad day, it's a zombie day.
Gotcha.
With your hair.
Yeah.
You know, maybe a little bit here. And not as much here, because I feel like maybe he got bit here. That was, like, where he got et.
Yep.
Somebody et Mark's brain. Poor Mark.
There's a lot of good votes in here for names. I saw Fritz.
And Fritz is good.
And Daryl. You know, for anyone who used to watch Bob Newhart.
My other brother, Daryl. Maybe another little hair over here. It's just really about these little short, little furtive word lines. I like those names.
Mm-hmm. I was going to vote for Ian.
Ian is good.
Because that's one of our community members who's another good diehard zombie.
I'm pulling down a little bit of a neck. It's not too long. And then, because this is a male, I'm going to make sure that I really define these side... What muscles are these called again?
What's that?
These muscles at the neck. Do you remember what they're called?
Mm.
Somebody in the community will know. And they will shout it out like 1,000 times. They'll be like, I'm a nurse, I know!
Or one of the weight training people.
Yeah.
Like, they're the trapezoid complex.
But since this is a male figure,
yep.
I definitely want to define those.
Yeah, I think trapezoid, clavicle, it's a clavicle maybe? That's a clavicle bone. Trapezoid muscle, I think it's the one in the back. I don't know.
I'll just paint him in here.
Dwight.
He's a biggin.
Some good votes out here for names.
Is there?
Yeah.
Just painting him in. That's all you really got to do for this. This piece is like... And you could really, like, you could, you know, on the bumper stickers on the back of cars has, like, the whole family?
Mm-hmm.
You could use this to tell a whole family story.
Mo Cuts is like, neck muscles. They're called neck muscles.
I like that. That's the best suggestion I've ever heard. Neck muscles. So we're going to leave him here like that for a minute. We're going to come to his little friend who's coming also to visit. And I'm going to change his, like, I'm going to make him even a little bigger. So that there's some more depth in this piece for him. Because I think I made this guy small. So we'll do that. And what's nice is it's just a half circle. Which you're like, dude, I can do a half circle.
We could go with
your figure drawing now.
We could go with the birthday names and call this one Pam or Susan.
This is true.
We could have all the birthdays in there.
I'm up for whatever the community wants to do.
But you'd have to add a third. You'd have to have a third zombie in there.
I'm going to peek a little ear out here and then also do like this little kind of hair. I've got a dry brush.
Uh-huh.
I'm just letting the way it's like sort of fluffy help me have fluffy hair.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to make sure that it's not really all the same direction because, you know, you don't have neat, coiffed hair when you're the undead. Nope. Free so, from caring about those simple, simple things.
So Fallen Sirens having trouble doing a half circle. Do you have any suggestions on that?
Having trouble doing a half circle.
Is it okay to trace a circle or use something
yeah.
to...
Oh, yeah. You know, if circles really bother you, trace around something that's the approximate size. Like, I could put, you know, this here and trace, you know, like, what would be back here more? Trace around it, and then you could just bisect it in half.
Okay. So it's okay to use a lid or something,
you know,
or trace?
I think sometimes it helps if you just do the line first and then try to do the half circle.
Hmm.
So those are two ways to get that done. There's a really good video on how to draw perfect circles, too, out in YouTube, but I don't know what it is, and it is not eye-carded, but it is genius.
Hmm. Yeah.
All right. I want to kind of work that hair, you know, for what's going on. And now I feel like we need a hand, so I'm going to move to an even smaller brush. Do you need a hand? I need a hand. This has been a hard week. I need a hand.
Is a stunt hand not enough?
Is it, this one is definitely the stunt hand. So right here, I'm going to kind of bring up a little hand. This is somebody, this isn't actually his hand. This is a friend who's like...
This is someone under the water?
Yeah, they're like reaching up going, what's happening? And so I want a tender little wrist, tiny little wrist.
We got an answer.
We do?
Yeah, Carrie said... the trapezius and pectoral are all connected to the clavicle in the neck and the shoulder area. Hmm.
That's
so,
kind of cool.
Pretty cool. We see, and the more you know.
So a little trip, I hope it helps for making a hand, is I like to bring the arm down to a tapered point, and that's where the wrist is. And then the hand is kind of this interesting little, it's not quite a triangle. Not quite a trapezoid, but it's this cool little shape. And I'm going to switch to a teeny tiny detail brush because I can't get little fingers with my big one. It is okay to use any traceables that you like. I'm going to pull this out. I think I'm going to make one for this. I'm going to pull this little thumb out here, come to the joint and curve it. And I'm going to let it go to a taper because I want the hand to feel kind of
tapery.
Tapery and clawish. And then I'm going to bring another little claw up here.
See, those are good gardening hands.
Those are. So really, the zombies are the heroes because there's mutant plants. And they're just trying to get them to be reasonable cabbages again.
Dude, if you've ever lived in Texas and had a lawn, you understand that your garden is not a reasonable thing. It just...
So we've got those little guys in. Pretty simple stuff, yeah?
Yeah.
I'm going to wipe my brush off, and I'm going to add just a little white to my black. Because I kind of don't want things to be totally perfect. So I'm going to come here and just add the hint. Very little of shading to this. Just because he would be in the fog or the mist. But I just want some dimension to the paint. You know, that layering. Some important stuff.
See, you keep switching on.
Come here more on the left, too. Yeah,
hold on.
Gotta
run the camera over there.
Oh. I'm just adding a little highlight here. Just a little bit to create a finished look. Whenever you're doing, like, a really noir piece, it's nice to create a finished look. I hope Mark's having a good birthday. He's really put up with a lot.
Mm.
I don't know why it became funny to not paint a zombie. Because Mark wanted a zombie. But at some point, it did get to be goofy fun. And I'm really glad that we got one in for him. Though I suspect this will be like one of three zombies over the holiday season. Because I had some other plans. I had to look at all the different kinds of plans I wanted. Now I'm going to have some eyes peeking up here.
Uh-huh.
Eyes peeking up here. And they're just white. And I think that I might pull the face down a little bit so I can do more of the eye in.
Okay.
Just adjusting. And I do this all the time. I'll adjust on the fly.
You want to just
a
little bit more?
So I'm going to finish that almond because I really like that in the original. And I see that I'm not quite capturing that here. So I'm going to make that adjustment. A little almond. And then I'll rinse out my brush and just pull the face down a titch. And you can do that super, super easily. See, not hard to say that this face is peeking out from here.
You just add a little bit more face there.
Yeah, you can always just do that. You don't have to. By the time the reflection gets in, you're all good.
Oh.
Just wanted the extra little, extra little room.
He just poked his head up a little more.
Yeah.
Said, hello.
Hello.
Do you need any gardening?
They do. They need gardening.
We're self-fertilizing.
One cute zombie. At some point during, you know, like that's fun for family paints.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to do one like intense facial zombie, I think. So this is very interesting on him. I actually did the,
what'd you do there?
I did the eyes more round, interestingly enough. And I didn't do them quite the same size. And that sort of implies a lot about the figure.
Yeah.
Like maybe they're more, you know how sometimes their eyes are kind of more buggy out or stuff is happening? It gives that impression that that's going on. And while that's drying, what we can start to do is put in these little shadows in the water.
Yeah.
And that's fairly easy to do. And that is about an all water, whether we're painting zombies in a smoky swamp like this.
Yeah.
Or whether we're painting a beautiful lake. One of the tricks that you got to keep going is the level reflections.
Oh, yeah.
It just makes such a difference in something looking like water. So I'm going to create these reflections. Another thing that I do in reflections is I don't just make, you know, dashes like this, which wouldn't really feel that much like water.
Mm-hmm.
I try to create, and I'll blend these together, these horizontal but uneven kind of zigzags. So even though I'm not looking at, you know, a water reference, it's still going to feel like water.
Yeah.
Yeah. How are you doing today?
Good. I just wanted to let you get that in, you know, finish explaining that. But we have over 220 people here celebrating birthdays with us today. Not everyone's having birthdays, but we're all celebrating the birthday, definitely, with your Mark, Pam, and Susan. And I wanted to say thank you, guys. Definitely post up your pictures. We'd love to see all the zombies that get made up on the Facebook page, Twitter, Instagram, any of those places. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share.
I know it's a little early in the season for zombies.
It's a little birthday zombie.
But
that's
okay. It's a birthday zombie, and we all
we're getting warmed up.
And other birthday people.
And other birthday people who've come along for this.
Who may not have wanted birthday zombies, but they're getting them now.
And we're going to have a traceable for this?
Yeah, I'm going to make a traceable.
Okay, cool.
I don't want people to worry about drawing.
And don't forget to go by shop.theartsherpa.com, where you can find all the shirts, hats, mugs, and stuff we do on this. And congratulations to amateur artist who passed her driving test. Congrats. I just saw that come up in chat.
Congratulations.
And for those of you guys who were asking there earlier on, our television schedule is posted up on our main YouTube page. And we are...
Oh, no, I had to take it down, babe.
Oh, you did? Oh.
That's right, because it had no sound.
That's right. I've got a new one that's going up there later on this afternoon. I thought... so you'll see it up there this afternoon. But we're in Houston, Texas. And we're on four channels here. And then also in...
Canton, Ohio.
Canton, Ohio on channel 15.
Because they called and they said, can we put it in Canton, Ohio? Yeah. We said, sure.
He said, absolutely.
If you like, I'm going to come back here.
Okay.
And I'm going to create a little reflection around my hand. The dark reflection implies that more stuff is happening beneath the water. I don't know if any of you ever read the Conan comics. May have just been me, but if any of you read the Conan comics, was something I always noticed that the artist...
Reading a Conan comic is a real...
Hey. just like, we've been married a long time, but don't start that off. I'm going to join this shadow sort of with this one a little bit and then bring it over. That's just, I can't believe you said that. Shocked, really. And what I'm trying to do is create a nice design in the shadow of the water.
So how far should you stretch those reflections out?
Well, I will try. I don't want to take them all the way across the page. What I find for me in reflections that is the most important when I'm painting is that they're not all of a uniform length.
Yeah.
That's what I want to avoid, is a uniform length with them. It's okay if they go behind a figure or they blend into each other, but you need short and you need long, and they need to sort of wander. See how I'm wandering?
Mm-hmm.
The wandering is one of those fun things that you get to practice in life. I love doing a wander. My daughter has a theme song for those. I'm going to give him a nice shadow. He's a little closer, so he's a little bigger. So you can kind of tell the distance of these objects, even though this is a very flat space, by their size and relationship to each other.
Ah.
Tells you which zombie is closest to you, even in this interesting piece.
I want a super close-up of him. Let's see if I can do that.
There's his little...
You get sound effects with him, though. Sorry.
I get sound effects?
Everyone gets sound effects with me. They just come.
I love it. Thank you. I'm so glad to be with you guys today. You just have no idea.
You know, if you had a robot camera, you would make sound effects too.
I'm sure I would. I'm going to switch to a bigger brush because objects that are closer to you in the picture plane will, like, when you're doing flowers, if you have a bunch of teeny tiny distant flowers, up here they need to be bigger. And so, same rule applies here, that I need to have larger and more prominent shadows.
Gotcha.
So I'll just switch to that bigger brush. And that's not really a problem. This is really an easy piece to do. I think a first-time painter could do this, especially with the traceable. And you could give this to any zombie fan in your life.
So we could call this a one-moan painting?
It's one moan.
Paint.
Right. Sorry. I'm just creating that sort of extra drama there, and you can see how that pulls that whole piece together.
Yeah.
Now,
what
the part that's going to make it really go, I'm going to get this small number two bright out, is my red.
Now,
and I'm going to come right up here on this head here, and I'm going to add a little red.
Let me just make sure, you know, let me get up there. Now, I want to make sure
are we good on time?
I think so. They wanted to make sure that we've answered the question, though, of, like, how long should those reflections be? And I think that...
Okay, so here's the rule about reflections. If they're far away, like this, they should be sort of blended out and not defined.
Yeah.
When you get into the mid-range field where your eye can see it, where that focus is, they'll be... These are like... Oh, that's like a 3-inch. This is like a 1-inch, a 1.5-inch. I'm kind of, the longest here is like a little longer than my hand, so it's like a 6-inch. But what it's really about is the size of these reflections in relationship to the size of these reflections and the fact that these are faded out.
Gotcha.
Creates the illusion of depth. So you want them longer and stronger here and shorter here in the middle. If you were seeing them, if your depth of field was very clear far back, they would be really tiny back here. That's also applies to nice stuff on the ocean.
Yeah.
And if that didn't quite explain it, I will keep going. I don't mind.
Yes. I think that's good.
Okay.
I think
so. I'm adding this little bit of blood to show, you know, he's had a day.
Those are zombie decorations.
And then I really like defining the jaw with the red here.
He's a messy eater. Likes pomegranates, clearly.
Clearly. And again, for those of you with small children, I do have a small child cute zombie coming. For those of you teenage
zombie
boys, you're now their hero. How's my mic? It got really high up in my face.
I think it's okay.
Okay.
I'm hearing you okay. I've been kind of adjusting around on the camera. So wow, we have.
I'm bringing this little blood rivulet down his chest.
Again,
it's going to come up over his clavicle. Sort of using some of my waterfall knowledge here. But also, blood is sort of sticky and has its own way that it likes to run. Maybe we'll just give him some. Here's some splatter. Think CSI.
Uh huh.
You know, use what you've learned from your cop shows. How does blood splatter work? What would Dexter say?
Yeah. I can tell you what brush splatter looks like. I have it all over the room.
They were murdered with a number 10 bright. And I'm going to take this blood into my water.
Uh-huh.
And this is why this could just be any red.
It's Ghost says it's Deadpool.
It could be. This one, he's cheeky enough. He could be.
It could be. He's just.
But he would have worn a red suit.
Maybe we just. Maybe he's going commando.
You know, he would. I think the thing I love about Deadpool, and this is a weird thing to love about this, but what I love about it is the bend to the fingers in the art style.
Oh, yeah.
I love that. It's so signature, and it hadn't really been done in that way. And it's something I always notice when I see that graphic work.
Yeah.
So I'm just trying to say, hey, there's stuff happening in this water. Isn't that lovely? Let's blood up our hand.
Okay.
Our hand's also been busy.
What's it been doing?
It's been doing something. And its little fingertips are red. Right?
Uh-huh.
Red fingertips. Nice touch.
Yep.
And then Owl will say that it runs down the hand and into the water. Isn't that nice? Isn't that lovely? It's a happy little blood trail. I'm sorry. I
What? I'm reading comments. I don't know what you just snuck something by me there.
I'm sure Bob forgives me. But you make your blood trails happy. Make them happy. He's happy. He feels much better. Now this guy, it's bubbling up from somewhere. And maybe we'll do a thing. I didn't do this in the first one, but do this now because I just think it's neat. Sorry. Sometimes you just want to tell a little story. And I'm pulling this red. And of course, just like I got, you know, I was much stronger in the black, I'm going to be much stronger in the red up front.
Uh-huh.
As you do.
As you do.
I might get a 4 brush, slightly bigger. Not as big as the 10 I put the other.
Now, what time did we start the other show at?
11:45.
Well, we're a little 5 over on that, so we're going to have to. I'll go over and adjust that thing.
Okay.
While we're doing this, real quick.
We're almost in here, but we
almost.
Just need a few minutes.
Oops.
Just a couple.
Just a couple minutes there.
Yeah, and then we'll.
Let me just
we'll
run
take
over.
This into another weird after show space. Which? I'm just adding this little red down here, and I want to fill this in stronger. So this little pool of blood will be just a little more noticeable. And these reflection strokes will be bigger, or blood strokes will be a little bit bigger. But you know, you can always also put in little kind of design dashes where you're breaking up the pattern. And that's what you're constantly trying to do, is break it up. You know, take a look at your work. Does it have the feel you're looking for? I don't know. I'm having a fun day, though.
So I think I need to set this for noon. Is that right? Yeah. Boom.
Now I'm going to add a little white. And this is the high reflection on my water. I'm going to still do this with a 4. So I'm going to come here and just add a little bit. Not a huge amount. You can kind of see I've just got it on the tip of my brush here.
Yeah.
I'm just coming in and giving some reflections. Avoid your red or dry your red before doing this, otherwise you'll get a bunch of pink, which you don't want, and it detracts. Unless these 8 little ponies. And then I guess it's a different story. These are my little pony zombies. Or brony zombies. I don't know. Then the water can be pink.
Okay. Sorry.
That's all I'm saying.
Well, gosh, we have over 225, 6, 7, 8 people here. So thank you guys all for coming and hanging out. And really, really love you guys hanging out with us today, celebrating the birthdays. And don't forget, we're going to have the after party after this. So you'll come and hang out, and we'll add some black light. And what else are we going to do there, Cinnamon?
I think some people asked if Kevin could come.
Maybe Kevin will come. That would be fun.
Yeah. I think they were missing Kevin. I'm just going to add some reflections here. Not a whole lot, but just a little bit of highlight. Just to create that finished sort of I am water little look.
Oh, they want you to take a picture beforehand, so this is for a shirt. They like that.
Oh, okay. And totally, if you guys want this as a shirt, this can be a shirt. These are my zombies, so I can shirt them. And then Mark will forever know he has a birthday.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the zombie of Mark that Chuck Carson did may be a shirt, too.
Yep. We'll probably have a couple of those available for you guys in the store, or at least for a little while.
For a little while.
For a little while. We may have a secret link that we'll
secret links.
I don't know if I can do those yet. Yeah. No promises. But they'll be...
No promises.
They'll All definitely right. be out there.
So you can keep just adjusting your water and your reflections till you feel like, you know, you have accomplished and gotten this feel of the imminent onslaught. See, there's like way more than this. These are just the first three you're seeing.
Mm-hmm.
Stuff's about to get real up in here.
Oh, there you go.
All right. I feel like we got it.
Yeah.
I want to definitely hope that you guys enjoyed painting your zombies. And thank you for joining us today. If you want to see these kind of punched up or kicked it up a notch with a Kraken and some glow paint, we're about to go do that. You can meet us in the link.
Yeah.
It's scheduled, so it's findable.
Yes, yes. We have the link. It's actually up there, so it'll start in about 10, 15 minutes. We're going to start
Perfect.
It at 12:10.
I'm going to get a cup of coffee.
Yeah.
And hey, everybody, happy birthday. And thank you for being the beautiful, creative people that you are. And I appreciate so much every positive, kind, wonderful thing that you do. And having you paint with us means the world to me.
We love you guys. They're all here with us, giving us thumbs up and love. And they're so people. Thank you, guys. Love you.